Praise God. Praise God once more.
Amen.
This is the beautiful day that the Lord has given unto us, and this is Brigade Week, and we shall start with prayers. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning saying thank you for the gift of life, God. God, I pray that, God, as you are going to start, I pray that you may be with us, start with us, and also end with us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Okay, now we shall invite the NCOs to give us the songs. Welcome.
These bones, they were made by the word of the Lord. And the head bone connected to the neck bone, and the neck bone connected to the shoulders bone, and the shoulders bone connected to the back bone. They were made by the word of the Lord. And the backbone connected to the hips bone, and the hips bone connected to the thighs bone, and the thighs bone connected to the knees bone, and the knees bone connected to the ankles bone, and the ankles bone connected to the tailbone. They were made by the word of the Lord. These bones, they were dry bones, they were made by the word of the Lord.
All the other gods,
they are the works of men, but you are the most high God. There is none like you.
All the other gods,
they are the works of men, but you are the most high God. There is none like you, Jehovah. You are the most high God. You are the most high God, Jehovah. You are the most high God. You are the most high God.
All the other gods,
they are the works of men, but you are the most high God. There is none like you,
Jehovah.
You are the most high God. You are the most high God, Jehovah. You are the most high God. You are the most high God.
Okay, let us sit down. Let us appreciate them with a hand of clap. Now we shall invite the NCOs again with a presentation. Let us welcome them with a clap again.
I've been on the mountain and valley slope. It seems I never had a place to go. Then I met Jesus and now he's mine. There is no mountain we cannot climb.
There is no mountain we cannot climb. When I say we, it's Jesus and me. Since I got Jesus, and the divine. There is no mountain we cannot climb.
I was in despair, trouble beset me. Tears filled my eye, I could not see. I trusted Jesus, his love divine. There is no mountain we cannot climb.
There is no mountain we cannot climb. When I say we, it's Jesus and me. Since I got Jesus and love divine. There is no mountain we cannot climb.
So many problems upon the earth, some of diseases and our lives. Believe in Jesus, he will be yours. There is no mountain we cannot climb.
There is no mountain we cannot climb. When I say we, it's Jesus and me. Since I've got Jesus in love divine, there is no mountain we cannot climb.
Don't be discouraged when troubles come. When people leave you, your very friends, cry out to Jesus and he will answer. There is no mountain I cannot climb.
There is no mountain we cannot climb. When I say we, it's Jesus and me. Since I got Jesus in love divine, there is no mountain we cannot climb. There is no mountain we cannot climb. When I say we, it's Jesus and me. Since I got Jesus in love divine, there is no mountain we cannot climb.
Okay, now we shall sing the brigade anthem. Let us stand.
Will your anchor hold in the storms of life when the clouds unfold their wings of strife? When the strong tides lift and the cables stray, will your anchor drift or firm remain? We have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll. Fastened to the rock which cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the Savior's love. We have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll. Fastened to the rock which cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the Savior's love.
We shall have our seats. Now we shall invite Madam Jenga to give us the lesson of today. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, Madam Pauline. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
People at home, our brigaders, the officers, our parents, everybody there, praise the Lord.
Amen.
We really thank God for yet another beautiful Sunday, Brigade Sunday, that the Lord has given us. We truly appreciate the way you have been with us. You have been supporting the work of the Boys and Girls Brigade. And we pray, we say a big thank you. And we pray that our good Lord will continue blessing you as you continue standing with us. Thank you, and you are most welcome for our lesson today. And our lesson today is about a loved vessel. We have, that is what we were given, a loved vessel. Here it is. That is our lesson today, a loved vessel. And we also have a theme for that. And we have our brigade theme, NCOs in Christ, kindly stand up and let us lead our theme. Our theme, 1, 2, go.
John 15:16, it says, you did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you.
Amen, amen. Thank you. That is our theme. And so now, as we start, I was asking myself, what is a vessel? If we think about a vessel, it has very many explanations. It can be like a bowl or something. But today, we want to think about what is a vessel according to the Bible. The explanation of a vessel, niliona, nilikuwa natafutiria ndio nione what is actually the explanation of a vessel biblically. And I realized it's a person into whom some quality such as grace is infused, a true vessel of God. And today, our lesson is about Gideon. You have seen where we are getting our readings from Judges 6, 11 to 24, and John 15, 9 to 17. And this man called Gideon was preparing or beating out wheat in the winepress to hide it from the Midianites. If you read the Bible well, when he was doing the job, an angel of the Lord came and sat where there was a tree. And this man had not seen the angel of the Lord. Gideon was very busy beating the wheat, and he was trying to hide because the Midianites were very bad to them. They could steal their food, they were beating them, they were killing them, they were waging wars. And so, for them to have food, you had to do it when you are hiding. And so this day, Gideon was beating the wheat in their home compound while hiding. And while he was there, an angel of the Lord appeared to him and said, "The Lord is with you, you mighty warrior." And he was annoyed. He asked the angel, "What are you saying? How can you say the Lord is with us? Why has this happened to us if the Lord is with us? Why are we going hungry? Why are we beaten? Why are our people killed?" He even asked the angel of the Lord, "Where is his wonderful deeds that our fathers told us? They used to tell us that God did so much in the wilderness. He gave them food in the wilderness. The seas and the rivers parted. But now it's like he has forgotten us." And the angel of the Lord was just quiet, listening to him complaining. But the Lord turned to him and said, this is what Gideon was told, "Go in the strength that you have and save Israel." Gideon could not imagine what the angel of the Lord said. "I go with the strength I have to go and save Israel." And he looked at the angel and then, after being told to go and save them, another voice came, "Am I not sending you?" And now he realized, your saut is your hivi-hivi. That must be God who is saying something. And so, he asked, "How can I save Israel?" And he continued, and the angel was quiet. "Remember, our family or our clan is the weakest, it's the poorest, it's the smallest. I cannot go and save Israel." And he continued, "Remember, I am the least in our family." Maybe he was the last born. So he was asking the angel of the Lord, "Our family is the smallest and the weakest. I'm the least. Maybe I'm the last born. How do you tell me to go and fight for Israel?" And I come to think about Gideon. When God wants to use you, he doesn't care whether you are the firstborn, the lastborn, whether you are very weak, whether you cannot stand, whether you are a stammerer like Moses. He doesn't care. If God wants to use you, you become a loved vessel. To him, you become a loved vessel. And he chose you. To God, he doesn't care who you are, what you are, what you do. And with that, I remember in the Bible, 2 Kings chapter 21, verse 1. There was this young man called Manasseh. He was only 12 years old, and God chose him to become a king. Imagine at 12 years, I was thinking, was he learned? Didn't he know what to do? But God chose him. He became a loved vessel by God. And he ruled for 55 years. He reigned for 55 years. Quick mathematic. He was only 12 years old. He reigned for 55 years. You tell me the answer later. Well, as if that was not enough, in 2 Chronicles, chapter number 34, verse 1, there was another one called Josiah. He was only 8 years old, and God chose him. And that's why our theme is saying, he chose us. We are not the one who chose God. And whenever he chooses you, you have to adhere to what he is saying. This young man, Josiah, was only 8 years old when he became a king. He became a loved vessel by the Lord. And God chose him. And he became a king. And he reigned for that 1 year. Just imagine, 8. Come to imagine. If an 8-year-old person in our country today is told to become the president, we will all complain and start saying, oh, he's too young, he knows nothing. But if you are chosen by God, he doesn't want to know your age. He doesn't want to know whether you are the last born. He doesn't know whether nyinyi munaka wapi. Even if you don't have a place to live, you don't have a big house, you sleep on the streets, you stay in the streets, when God chooses you, he's the one who chose you. You are not the one to choose him. And so, for us to qualify, we need qualification for us to be chosen by God. Number one, we have to obey his word. Period. There is no other thing, but you have to obey God's word. And again, you have to be faithful to his word. You have to be faithful. And again, you have to listen to God's voice. Because when he comes, now if we go back to Gideon, he argued that, you see, our family is the weakest and I'm the least. And then he realized, oh, I'm telling God what he knows. He agreed to be used by the Lord. He obeyed. Number two, he became faithful. Number three, he listened carefully to God's voice. And because of that, when he went with the strength that he had to fight the Midianites, those who had disturbed them, those who were almost killing them, they were always killing and eating their food. When he went to fight them, he drove them away, and the Israelites lived in peace because he used. Now, when we are listening to God's voice, there are things that we need to know. Sometimes God might use your voice. And that's why you see some people can sing so well, very nice, soft voice. They sing so nicely. And when God gives you such a voice, you have to use it. Otherwise, you'll come for it and hit you very hard. And there are people who are given soft talking, soft voices. When they come and find you fighting, you want to kill one another, fighting and very angry. They are so soft, they calm you down until you stop fighting, because that is what God gave him. He's a loved vessel, and God wants him to use his soft voice to calm people down. And when God comes, like the way he came to Gideon, and tell you, use the strength that you have. So you have to go to war and be ready to fight. May God help us to obey him, to be faithful to him, to hear his voice. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. And I want us once again to remind people that God chose us. We did not choose him. It's him who chose us. It's him who keeps us going. It's him who gives us what we really ask for. Once again, let us tell the people at home, stand up. And let us tell them once again the theme.
You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you.
Amen, amen. Thank you, and yours. May God help us to know that he chose us. We did not choose him. And so we obey, we become faithful, and do whatever he wants. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Let us appreciate Madam Jenga once again for the good word. So children at home, you've heard the word, and so keep that word in your heart. You should know that God can choose you. It does not matter at which age. God can choose you at any time, at any age. So I hope you are blessed, and God bless you once again. Amen? Okay, now we shall invite Elder James Kimani to pray for us. Welcome.
Praise the Lord, church.
Amen.
I am James Ngaru, not James Kimani. I want to thank God so much for this chance that he has given us. Thank you, Madam Jenga, for that wonderful lesson and reminding us that you have been chosen. So even you at home, you have been chosen. And so I want us to pray. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you so much for giving us a chance and opportunity to sit at your feet and, Lord, to hear your word. Thank you for our sister, Lord, who has shared with us and reminded us that, Lord, you've been chosen. And, Father, we thank you that this week the brigade have been very busy. And, Lord Almighty, they have been doing all things because they've been chosen of you. Thank you, Lord Almighty, for our children who are at home and who are watching us this morning. Lord Almighty, they have been chosen of thee. We thank you, Lord, as you help each one of us to keep that word and, Lord, live according to that word, dear Master. Father, Lord, we want to pray for all the children in the brigade, even in the church school, and even all those that are at home, O God. We want to declare your blessings upon them, Heavenly Father. We want to pray, Lord, that your protection shall be upon them, even during this time of the world pandemic, dear Master. We pray that you shall keep our children safe. And the Lord Almighty, at the end of it all, your name shall be glorified, your name shall be honored. We pray for the parents who are working very hard to ensure that, Lord Almighty, they are able to bring these children in a godly way. We pray the Lord Almighty, you bless them. And even those many others who have lost opportunities during this time of COVID-19, those who have lost jobs, those who have lost businesses, Lord Almighty, we pray the Lord Almighty, as your word says, that the birds of the air do not toil, they don't moil, but they eat, O dear Master. How much more important are we in your sight? Father, Lord Almighty, that we pray that you remember such families and come in for them to the glory and of your holy name. We thank you, Lord Almighty, as a church, we continue to praise your name, we continue to glorify you. Remembering our nation, our country this morning, even our leaders who are at the forefront fighting this pandemic, Lord, we pray for special grace, we pray for special favor. May you continue being revealed upon our lives. Bless us, Lord, and be together with us. For this is our prayer of faith. We pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And now may the grace
of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.
Amen. Amen.